Listen to yourself, Bob. You follow her to work. You eavesdrop on her calls. You open her mail. The minute you started doing these things, the relationship was over. Thank you for your call. Rosa, I think we have time for one more.
Yes, Dr. Crane. On line 4, we have Russell from Kirkland.
Hello, Russell. This is Dr. Frasier Crane. I'm listening.
Well, I have been feeling sort of, you know, depressed lately. My life's not going anywhere. It's not that bad. It's just same old apartment, same old job. Sometimes
Russell,
we're just about at the end of our hour. Let me see if I can cut to the chase by using myself as an example. 6 months ago, I was living in Boston. My wife had left me, which was very painful. Then she came back to me, which was excruciating. On top of that, my practice had grown stagnant, and my social life consisted of, well, hanging around a bar night after night. You see, I was clinging to a life that wasn't working anymore, and I knew I had to do something, anything. So I ended the marriage once and for all, packed up my things, and moved back here to my hometown of Seattle. Go Seahawks. I took action, Russell, and you can too. Move, change, do something. If it's a mistake, do something else. Will you do that, Russell? Will you? Russell, I think we lost him.
No, we cut to the news 30 seconds ago.
Well, for crying out loud. I finally bare my soul to all of Seattle, and they're listening to Chopper Dave's Rush Hour Roundup. Well, the rest of the show was pretty good. It was a good show, wasn't it?
Here, your brother called.
Roz, in the trade, we call that avoidance. Don't change the subject. Tell me what you think.
Did I ever tell you what this little button does?
I am not a piece of Lalique. I can handle criticism. How was I today?
Let's see. You dropped 2 commercials. You left a total of 28 seconds of dead air. You scrambled the station's call letters. You spilled yogurt on the control board, and you kept referring to Jerry with the identity crisis as Jeff.
You say my brother called. Mm-hmm.